Today on Versus, we are going to recreate our own version of the IKEA furniture set. This set has a suggested retail price of $17.99. We found it at IKEA in the children's section. It comes with a pink couch. It's pretty low to the ground and hollow underneath. It's made of plastic with a fabric cover. Here is a simple green coffee table, a yellow chair, a cube shelf, a black and white rug, and a throw pillow. And their box is usable. It has a lot of little cutouts in it. So maybe we'll make a box too. So let's make that first. I take foam board, measure, and cut a 12 by 15 rectangle. And remember to always have adult supervision when working with sharp objects. I cut another one that is 15 by 13, then two more that are 13 by 12. On the 13 by 12 rectangles, draw and cut out large doorways. Take the cutout, cut it into strips, glue them around the opening to make a door frame. I did this on both of the side walls. The frame adds a little strength since we cut a large portion out of the wall. Take the 13 by 15 inch rectangle, cut the ends off of popsicle sticks, glue them onto the foam board to make a hardwood floor. Glue on the walls, use leftover trim around the bottom of the walls to make our box. We still have some leftover foam board, so I measure and cut 7 by 4 inch rectangles. I have 6 of those. Then I cut 7 by 3 inch rectangles. I cut 3 of those and 4.5 by 3 inch. I have 6 of those. Stack and glue 3 together. Repeat for the last 3. Then stack and glue the other rectangles together. So we have 4 pieces. Use glue to cover them with felt. I like to add a lot of glue around the edges to seal it in. Neatly trim off the excess to make neatly covered boxes. Take the large one, glue on the back, then the sides to make a couch. Glue beads underneath for added height to make a couch. These are pretty much the same size and the foam is surprisingly sturdy, but our couch is a little deeper. I have a little foam left over, so I cut out rectangles, glue them together to make a cube shelf just like the IKEA one. I found this black and white printed felt at the craft store. It was 77 cents. We can use this for the rug in our room. Wow, that rug took up the whole floor, and we could cut it down if we choose. Next, let's make a table. I take recycled paperboard and cut it into a bunch of 2.5 by 2.5 inch squares. Stack and glue them together in groups of 4, then stack and glue those together, turning a little bit each time, creating a spiral. I continued until it was about the same height as the IKEA table, which is about 2.25 inches tall. Paint it. I used a gold acrylic paint to make a small table for our room. I think this is looking pretty good. Up next is the chair. They have a plastic yellow chair, so I'm just gonna make a yellow beanbag. This is a fabric quarter I got for 97 cents at Walmart. I fold it accordion style. Lightly sketch a wedge on the top layer. This one is about 19 centimeters long. Cut on the lines drawn, cutting through all the layers at once. So I have 5 pieces. Line up the edges and sew them together, one side at a time, leaving an opening at one end so it can be turned inside out. Add fluff, add a few fabric scraps for weight, sew the opening closed to make a beanbag chair. Use the leftover red felt to sew pillows to go on the couch. The IKEA box has these little cutouts that you can use to decorate the space. They look hand-drawn, so maybe we can do something similar, like artwork for our walls. I have a square of leftover foam board. Using a pen and a ruler, draw lines. for a very simple design, hang it on the wall to complete our IKEA-inspired room. So now we can take a look at the DIY versus the store. They have the same number of items. The IKEA playset is made of plastic, so it is very sturdy. And this is a very cool shaped chair. Our couch, coffee table, and beanbag are also pretty sturdy. They will stand up under a lot of play. And honestly, this coffee table could knock somebody out. It is pretty dense. However, the shelving unit does need to be handled with care because it's made of foam board. The rugs feel almost exactly the same, and both take up about the same amount of space. But let's talk about the cost, because this definitely cost me some time. True, this took me about a day and a half to build, whereas this was just, you know, walking in the store and buying it, which cost $17.99. And this was, I used two pieces of foam board from the dollar store, which cost me $2, two packs of popsicle sticks that were 97 cents each at Walmart, four pieces of red felt for 33 cents each, 77 cents for the rug, and $1 for the fabric, bringing my total to $7.03, not counting beads, paint, and glue, because I already had those. Let us know which one is your fave, the DIY or the store, in the comments down below. Like, comment, share, and subscribe. Don't forget to ring the bell and follow us on Instagram at MyFroggyStuff and the Frog Vlog.
And you're done.
Happy crafting!
To give a shout out to Jess Bean One. What's up? I am really happy with how this room turned out.
Wait, who does this room even belong to?
I just kind of made it. I was feeling inspired.
So we are making random rooms for no one? When do I get my room?
Working on it. Gotta go.